Hi everyone, my name is Minister Catherine Edith of the Fraser family. I used to be a Flamand, but I'm not a Flamand anymore. I've been separated for over 10 years and that was my married name, so I'm going back to my maiden name. Actually, there's no last names in the Bible, so I'm wondering if I should even go by my last name, but that's another subject. I'm the woman they're talking about. Actually, Tony Blaze of the Edmonton Sun is talking about on Wednesday, March 21st, 2012, in this. That was the ad that was written about myself, and I would like to read it to you. It starts off, Edmonton's Catherine Flamand is apparently on a mission from God, and that mission includes driving her pursuit chariot without a license, registration, or insurance. Now, I'm going to tell you why. First of all, I'm not a driver. I will tell you what driver means here in the Black's Law Dictionary, 9th edition. It's the most recent one. And this is what they use in courts. They have different meanings of words than what we were taught. Now it says the driver, it says it is a person who steers and propels a vehicle. Now I am saying that I am not a person, and I'll tell you what. A person in the very same one says a human being, also termed natural person. Now the word person comes from the word persona. And a persona is that's person of incidence. The person against whom a right is enforceable, a person who owes a legal duty. But persona, P-R-S-O-N-A, a persona is a mask worn on a stage. That means it's a fake being. Persona. A person, an individual human being. Now, what I've been taught is human means monster. And that was years ago in an old dictionary. But persona, like I said, it's a mask worn on a stage. And also a person is that all capital, dead in law, fictional name that they put on your driver's license, insurance, registration, all your bills, your Visa, your MasterCard, anything with that all capital name is a person. You are not a person. You're a man or a woman. Now, the reason why I started this is because I've been learning about all this stuff, and I've been learning about how much of a fraud and how de facto, or unfortunately, how our government is. I'll finish reading this. But that's why I'm not a driver, because I'm not employed. In a lot of the meanings of driver, it says one employed, and I'm not employed. I'm a traveler. When I go over for my groceries, I'm a traveler. I'm just going to get my groceries. I'm not getting paid for it. The 52-year-old minister of the Church of the Ecumenical Redemption International has filed a constitutional challenge against the 3 Traffic Safety Act tickets she was issued and is slated to argue her case in court on April 20th. Now, the proctor of her church stood up for me on April 20th because he knows a lot more about this stuff than I ever did. I've only been doing this for 3 years. I just became a minister 3 years ago. I don't have to be ordained by man. I just have to be ordained by Yahuwah, which is God. They've even took God's name out of the Bible 7,000 times. Now, there's a reason why they don't want you to know the Bible. It's because there are freedoms and inheritances in it, and they don't want you to know that. They also don't want you to know that we are all equal. And they also don't want you to know that there's about oaths in there, about swearing oaths. And do not add to my law, do not take away from my law. That's what Yahuwah says. Okay, and then it's in big letters, religious beliefs. According to court file documents, Flamand wants a judge to quash the tickets based on religious beliefs. It's not just strictly on religious beliefs, it's the fact that there's a fraud going on. And if I'm talking to you today, they probably put me in jail for 3 traffic tickets. They're going to try and make me look like I'm crazy. And they're going to say that I'm doing treason or something, but I'm not the one doing treason, they are. I am being the watchman in Ezekiel 33, 6 through 10. It says that you're to warn people if you know what is coming, and I'm here to warn you. Please just hear me out, and I've got all kinds of documentation here that you can read, and you will find out that I'm not lying. She argues in her February 27th notice of constitutional issue that the provincial civil laws do not apply to her because she is a Christian minister who is only bound by God. Now, I did not say that. I said that they do not apply to me because it's not in the Ten Commandments. There is only Ten Commandments, which is so much sense and so good to live by. Anything else is man-made law. We are all supposed to be equal. Who has the authority to tell you that you need a piece of paper to travel to the store back and forth? And I'll explain later why. According to the court documents, Flamand was pulled over by police in her 1994 Mercury Sable on February 20th, 2011 at the intersection of 104th Street and 107th Avenue. After the officer noted there was no license plate on the car. Now, I had sent them a picture of my license plate that I was going to use. This is my license plate that I had made up. It's a Bible scripture. Now, there's a decision by John Rook that was also in the paper, a decision. It's called Meads versus Meads. You can go and type in Meads versus Meads. It's a 180-page document, and he's just shooting down the church, and he's shooting down anybody that tries to protect themselves in court. And they have such fraud going on, they won't listen to anybody. It's all about the money. It really is, and I will show you why. He talks about me making my own plate, which I did. I was very straight with them. Jesus said in I'm going to start with Matthew 5:25 first. I will read that to you. Okay, in 1953, the Queen, which is the head of our monarch, she is the head of state. She is the Commonwealth. Sorry, I'm pretty nervous. In 1953, she took a coronation oath where she said that the Bible, the King James Bible, that she will protect with all of her power. You can go type in Queen's Coronation Oath of 1953, and you will see her saying that she swears on the Bible that it will be the life and government of Christian princesses. And that Bible was supposed to be put in every single courtroom in Canada, and they have taken it out. Why? Because of their scam. When you go and swear on the Bible, you're not really swearing because it's the wrong Bible. They got the Gideon Bible in there. I know because I asked for one and they said there was not one in the courthouse. Okay, Matthew 5:25. It says, agree with thine adversary quickly while thou art in the way with him, lest at any time the adversary deliver thee to the judge and the judge deliver thee to the officer and thou be cast in prison. So in other words, get an agreement with them. Tell them what you're going to do, and that's exactly what I do. Now Matthew 18:15-20 says, moreover, if thy brother shall trespass against thee, go and tell him his fault between thee and him alone. That's a private agreement, and I've got one with so many people here in Edmonton and Alberta, like all the higher-ups. If he shall hear thee, thou hast gained thy brother. Okay? Now 16 says, but if he will not hear thee, then take with thee one or two more, that in the mouth of two or three witnesses every word may be established. So you take your agreement that you gave them so many days to answer, which they didn't. I gave Alison Redford, she was the Justice Minister, Attorney General at the time, I gave her 30 days to give me an answer, and I told her if she didn't answer me that she agreed by tacit consent. That means you agree by silence. Now, I told her that I was going to be traveling and not driving anymore because I didn't want a driver's license, insurance, and registration because Yahuwah says we don't need it. Now, I got the second agreement. I sent in the same one, but with signatures from the church, a couple of people from the church, and I gave her another 10 days. That was on July 29th, 2010. Now, they didn't answer me there again, too. Allison Renfer didn't. And so 17 says, and if he shall neglect to hear them, tell it unto the church. But if he neglect to hear the church, let him be unto thee as an heathen man and a publican. Wow. So the third time, all this time I was not traveling. The third thing I did was went and put it in the newspaper that I had a private agreement. That's telling the church, that's telling all the Christians. And it was put in the paper right here. It says, Minister Catherine achieved a private agreement with Allison Redford and all the people I've had a private agreement with. And that was like the mayor and the minister of transportation, the city solicitor, the police chief. Like, I was very diligent, and not one of them has answered me back. Again, I say unto you that if two or of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father who is in heaven. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in the midst of them. Okay, so I got my agreements with them, and that went on for 7 months. I was traveling here and there. I've had my plate on. I've had cops pull up beside me, behind me. I've had one follow me for about 10 blocks and never stop me. I had three witnesses in my pursuit chariot. By the way, pursuit chariot is a name that one of my friends came up with, and I kind of thought it was neat. Like, I've heard many funny names before, but I wanted a name. It wasn't associated to commerce, the commercial activity, because I was not getting paid to travel. I really hope I'm explaining this right. I'm very new to this, so please bear with me. After I got my agreements, I get a phone call on, actually, Allison Redford stepped down on February 18th, 2011. Now, I didn't go anywhere the next day after she stepped down, but the day after that I did, which was on February 20th. I went over to, a friend of mine called and wanted me to come over and talk to them, so I went over to minister to them. While we were sitting on the steps in the apartment building I was at, oh, first of all, I backed into, it was a lot of snow that year. There was like 4 feet of snow, and I backed into to the snowbank, so there's no way they could have seen my plate. Not that I was hiding it or anything, that's just the way I parked. So I was sitting on the steps with my friend, and all of a sudden I look out, and there I see cops. So I'm thinking, okay, they're just doing their rounds. But about 2 minutes later, there they were again. And they went up and down that street about, I'd say, 15 times. I think they were waiting for me to come out because Allison Renfer stepped down, and she told them to come after me. To me, that's entrapment. And this was after I had all my agreements in place, and they didn't answer me. And I told them they were going to be agreeing by tacit consent if they didn't answer me. I'm looking for my letter to Allison Redford. When I went to court on the constitutional challenge, it was a joke. I mean, they all got false oaths there. The whole provincial court has a false oath. So that means it's fraud. They took their oath just to get their job. It's all about the money. It is big business to them. Oh, that's the wrong one. I've got so much paperwork here that I've sent them. It's unbelievable. So I've got tons of proof. Where is it? I even showed them a picture of my pursuit chariot. So I was very open with them, very honest. Oh, I can't find my original one right now, to Allison Redford. It was more or less asking her if she can stop me from traveling in my private capacity. Now, after that policeman, Kyle Westergaard, he was very rude. He actually threatened me. He told me to get out of the car, I'll haul you out, after I told him I had agreements with the then police chief was David Corral. And he said, "Who's David Corral?" And I said, "Your boss." He didn't even know who he was. So here's my tickets here. But I went down in 72 hours, and right at the bottom here it says refuse for fraud, because that's exactly what they're doing with the all capital name. I'll tell you why. The all capital name was made up. It's called a straw man name. That's not really your name. You were taught in school, if you go look at a curriculum act of your province, you will see that your proper name is spelled with a, like mine would be a capital C and a small a, small t, a small h, a small e, and so on. And your middle name is a capital first letter, and the rest are all small. We were all taught that in grade one. So who gave them permission to take your name and do whatever they wanted to with it to make money? And they do, and they, every time you get one of these tickets, it's got a money monetary value at the bottom of it. And they go and they trade you on the stock exchange. That's slavery. The all capital name, Yahuwah talks about it a lot in the Bible. You go look in the Bible in the back and look up the word name, and there's all kinds of things on it about how they're taking your name and abusing it, which they also did with his. But like I said, I have done everything I was supposed to do, and they were not honorable whatsoever. They did nothing but intimidate. I hurt nobody. There's no injured party whatsoever in this incident. But I was very diligent, and I went and I did what I was supposed to do, what Yahuwah told me to, according to the Bible that the Queen took an oath to, and also every public servant is supposed to take an oath to. In 1955, they changed the oath to suit their own needs, and they took the word do out of it, which is the action word. So it makes that oath grammatically incoherent, so that means it's a false oath. So everything that they have done since 1955, every judge, every commissioner, every lawyer, prosecutor, should all be paid back to the people, because it's fraud. It's fraud. I repeat it, it's fraud. When we were born, that's a slavery. When we were born, our parents signed a birth certificate. And that was where the 13 families that own the world. If you go type in 13 families, you'll find all kinds of information about the 13 families that rule the world. They run it. And they're evil. They bought us at birth, of course, without telling our parents what they were doing. You try and get your statement of live birth and see how many security guards come with it. It's your property. It's yours. Why is there security guards with it? Our parents signed us away at birth without even realizing it. So that makes that contract null and void, because they were supposed to get the full unedited disclosure to that contract, just like every contract. And then they paid our parents what is called a family allowance, or child, what was it? You know what I mean. Family allowance, mother's allowance, whatever it's called. But that's how they paid for you. Now, when you turn 18, you're intimidated into going and getting a social insurance number, because they tell you if you don't, you can't work. That's intimidation. And you go willingly and do it without even knowing what you're doing. Hence, social insurance number, SIN. And then we let them change our names without even realizing. I remember phoning up one time and asking, "Why is my name all capitalized?" And they said, "Oh, no, it's just the database and I can't change it." I said, "Listen, I know how to build databases and I know you can change that." And they didn't even know. A lot of them don't know. But a lot of them do too. So this is how the slavery is. They take your name, They put a money value to it. They give you all these tickets. That's man-made laws. They make up these laws as you go. Who are they? We are all equal. Who are they to make up all these laws just to make money? Like, they're billionaires. They have robbed us blind for so long. There's the Westminster Confession of Faith that you can read. There's the British North American Act, Schedule 5. That's how the oath is supposed to be formed. And it's got the word do in it. And that's the oath that they're supposed to take, which they didn't take. So, total fraud. The Federal Oath of Allegiance Act. The Interpretation Act. The Governor General Act. The Preamble. There's all kinds of proof out there. My court date is on October 23rd, 2012, and I'm not going because I have a lawful excuse, and my lawful excuse is that they're de facto. There's the meaning of de facto here, and I'm going to read it to you. De facto government, one that maintains itself by a display of force against the will of the rightful legal government and is successful, at least temporarily, in overturning the institutions of the rightful legal government by setting up its own in lieu thereof. And that's exactly what they did. Canada. There's a place called Dun and Bradstreet where you can go in and type companies' names. And if you type in Canada, it will come up as an all capital name. And that means they're buying, selling, and trading us on the stock exchange. The birth bond is so well hidden, it's unbelievable. If anybody knows anything about the birth bond, please post it down below in the comments. I would really appreciate that because I don't know much about it. Like I said, I've been doing this for 3 years. All this stuff I've really caught on to because I've seen a lot of stuff go on and I've seen a lot of misery happen. There's no smiles on people's faces anymore. Now this here is the Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms, and in section 32 and 52, I'll read 32 for you. This is saying that this is our rights and freedoms. No, it's not. This is our rights and freedoms, the Bible. And they're scared of this Bible because they don't want you to know the truth. Okay, section 32. This charter applies to the Parliament and Government of Canada in respect of all matters within the authority of Parliament, including all matters relating to the Yukon Territory and Northwest Territories, and to the legislation and government. So that means this applies to them. Anybody who works for the government, this applies to them. This does not apply to you as a private man or woman. So that means that the criminal code don't apply to you because it's a spin-off of this, I guess you could call it. And 52 says, the Constitution of Canada is the supreme law of Canada. No, it's not. It says right here on the very same thing, right at the very top. Whereas Canada is founded upon principles that recognize the percent, sorry. Whereas Canada is founded upon principles that recognize the supremacy of God and the rule of law. Now, they've got this. That's God's law, which is only 10, actually 11. It says, do not add to my law. Do not take away from my law. This is adding to their law. The criminal code is adding to the Bible's law. So you got this for is the rule of law, the Bible. And anything after that only applies to the government. I hope you understand that. It does not apply to a private man or woman. I wanted to let them know that I don't want them to use that all capital name for me anymore because I'm not going to be a slave anymore because that's how they make you a slave. The agreements I had, boy, there was a lot of them. I also told them that they would be breaking 122 of the criminal code, which is breach of trust, 176 of the criminal code, which is obstructing a clergyman. They can give 14 years for that. And I told that cop right away I was a minister, because here's my proof of existence thing saying that I am a minister. It's got a picture of me, and it tells him that I'm a minister. 180 is nuisance, I think, and 423 is intimidation. Or I got those two backwards, I'm not sure. The Ten Commandments, in the third commandment, it says, do not make any graven images. That's what a license is. It's a graven image. Okay, there's my, this is, I told them I had to keep this for identification purposes, because a lot of people will not accept anything else except a government ID. And I told them that right in my letter that I was keeping it for identification purposes. Now it says Flamand, all in capital letters. My last name is not my first name. Where do you see all capital letter names? Well, the only place I've ever seen them was on headstones or obituaries. That means they're dead. Dead in law. Dead. Now, in the newspaper, if you read the obituary columns and then turn the page, you'll see the live birth announcements and everybody's name is spelled properly. Please do your research. Don't listen to anybody. Just do your research. That decision that John Rook made in the Meads versus Meads case is absolutely ridiculous. It's telling us that there's no justice whatsoever, that we can't go and defend ourselves. That's exactly what they're saying. They're not even allowing clerks to take any of our defense whatsoever. That is a total obstruction of justice. Now, I wrote to the police chief here complaining about the false oath. I am placing this formal complaint to you for your unbiased and unconflicted investigation into the false oaths of all judges and prosecutors and lawyers that have sworn in Alberta in violation of the Federal Oaths of Allegiance Act, in violation of 126 of the Canadian Criminal Code, which applies to them, as well as several other acts of Parliament, and the intimidation being applied by these men and women in these positions of trust to violate the commands of Yahuwah. Yahuwah is God to me. That's what I call him. Now he has, I've not heard anything from him. I went and I charged the two cops that stopped me because of my agreements I had. And it was 7 months. Why did they not answer me? It's their public duty to answer me. And I told them right in the letter that they agree by tacit consent, which is silence. That means you agree. So I thought I was safe when I went out on February 20th there, and when that cop stopped me. But obviously I wasn't, and he threatened me. He also gave me those three tickets, which are absolute fraud. And I told him to do not print it in the all capital name, because that's fraud. And he still did. It's still right there. Oh, you can't see it. Can you see it? All capital first. My last name is not my first name again. I did exactly what Yahushua told me to. I called Jesus Yahushua. I even sent Allison Redford, when she was Justice Minister, a letter. This notice is to inform you that I've changed my church plate, because the first one I made out was out of paper. Now, I'm doing this for freedom. Nobody has any authority over you. Who do they think they are, making up all these laws just to get money out of you? You wonder why you're broke all the time. Now, if I was to get into an accident, which I never have, I've been paying insurance for many years, my husband and I, and then I did for many years. That reminds me, when my husband and I first split up, he was supposed to be paying my insurance, and he stopped paying it, and I didn't know it, and I was traveling around thinking I had it, because you can get a year sticker but pay monthly, right? And I was traveling on in Lloydminster one time, which is 2.5 hours from where I am now. And I had my son at home and my dog. My son was 12. And they stopped me. And I went to court and they gave me a $3,975 fine. Now, I had just separated from my husband. I was very poor. I could not afford it. It's called indigent. That means poor. And I told them that and they didn't care. It was all about the money. If you don't pay the fine, they'll get it off your birth bond anyway. So they get it twice. Actually, they do three things with it. They take it off your birth bond, they get it off of you, and then they sell that piece of paper to the stock exchange because it's money, right? Anyway, I couldn't pay it, so the cop came right to my door and took me to jail in Lloydminster. He put me in shackles and chains like I was some sort of murderer. There was no injured party whatsoever. Nobody got hurt. All it was paper that he wanted, and I didn't have it. I didn't even know at the time I didn't. I was 42 years old. So they threw me in jail overnight, and then in the morning, and they took my bra, and in the morning they threw me in a paddy wagon in shackles and chains and took me all the ways to Edmonton in the back of the paddy wagon, which was absolute torture. It's just a little steel little room that you got to sit in, and it was really hard on the butt. And then I spent 3 weeks in there, and I was getting checked for drugs all the time and shot down, and it was horrible. It was torture. It was unbelievable. I hurt nobody. My son was home alone and my dog was there, and I lost my house. I lost everything I owned because of it. My son ended up having to go and stay with my niece, and I'm glad she was there. But I tell you, they just don't care. They have no morals, no values. It's all about money, and they want every dime you make. Told you about person. Please go look up the word person. Do some research on it. And even Yahuwah says that he is no respecter of persons. That's in 2 Samuel 14, 14. And Proverbs 24, 23, and 28, 21. Many times it says in there that he has no respect for persons. Now, I did this all according to the Bible that they swore to. They're going to try and make me look like I'm crazy. They don't want me to let people know this. They're going to try and say that I've committed treason and they're the ones who's committing treason. I'm just being a watchman and letting you know what's going on. So please, please do your research. I've been researching this for a while. Charlie Sprinkle is a man in the United States who decided that he was going to travel. And he decided that he was going to charge Ronald Reagan's wife, and all of Ronald Reagan's staff with fraud. And they stopped him one day and told him that he can travel with no license, insurance, and registration. And he did for 40 years. He passed away now. Go type in Charlie Sprinkle in YouTube, and his video will come up, and he will explain to you how he has done it. But I have done exactly what Yahuwah told me to do, and now they're intimidating me. They're going to throw me in jail all over civil code violation. If you go look at 176 of the Canadian Criminal Code, which applies to them, not to me, I'm not making use of it. I'm just warning them. It says that obstruction of a clergyman while in the performance of the functions of their calling, and that's exactly what they did. They obstructed me, they intimidated me, they threatened me. It's all about bullying. That's all they do is bully. And you see all the police brutality on TV and on YouTube. Now, a lot of these cops don't know, but some do. They have their names are also being used in the all capital form, the dead in law name. You got to know who you are. I know who I am. And I am not the all capital name. I'm not dead. I'm alive. I'm right here talking. There's all kinds of information out there. And Rod Connect, the new police chief, sent over a policewoman and a nurse to see if I was crazy. I couldn't believe that, all because I wrote him a letter asking to check about the oath. That's how scared they are. They're intimidated. They want me in jail, so I'm not letting people know what's going on. But If they put me in jail over this, I swear I will not eat or drink anything. I've had a friend thrown in jail, and they put him in there for 7 months over having God's gift of Genesis 1:29 and Romans 11:29. And when he went in, he was pretty healthy, but when he came out, oh boy, was he sick. He used to be a tenant of mine. I used to be a landlady. And now we live in a house, and he lives in the basement. And his room is below mine, and I heard him throwing up every night, and he was in agony every night. So I do not trust their food. It's because of who he was. He's actually the proctor of our church, and he's the one who's teaching us all of this. But he was treated terribly. He wasn't allowed phone calls. There was just so much that they intimidated him with. They threatened him to shut up. He was telling people in jail about this stuff, and they were listening, and he was doing Bible studies, and they were just intimidating him left, right, and center. What a horrible place that is. 98% of the people should not be in there. Unbelievable. Like I said, there's only 10 laws. Which would you rather go by, 10 laws or man's law of 50,000? I'm exaggerating, but that's pretty close. It's getting to a point where we're not going to be allowed to do anything according to them. We have to realize that we're all equal. Now, I've been paying insurance, like I said, my husband and I've never had an accident. Who does that money go to that I've paid into all these years? And why should they get it? They are no better than you or I. None of them are. It's all a corporation. Canada, Australia, England, all corporations buying, selling, and trading on the stock exchange. And the Queen said that she would defend the faith with all of her power. It seems like they're defending every faith except Christianity. And it says right in the Bible there that to act like a Christian. Now, they've been brainwashing people all these years with TV. They've got total control of the media. They've got total control of the food, the gas, everything we need. They've made us depend on them on purpose. I was never taught how to survive on my own in school, and I don't think you were. You have to go and learn on your own. Ignorance of the law is no excuse, so I've learned the law. And to me, this is way better law than what man has, because man, it's all about power and money. I don't have money. John Rock, you say that we charge for information. I would like you to prove that we have charged a penny for the information that we get. I've gotten a few donations, like a printer and ink and stuff like that, but that's about it. We don't charge anything. You said in there in one instance that we're rich, we're charging a lot of money, and then in another one it says that we're poor. Which one is it? You're contradicting yourself. That makes you look crazy. And you're calling us parasites because we know the truth. You don't want people to know the truth, John Rook, Gail Vickery, Stephen Bilodeau. You are the bad people. You are the evil doers. I am doing my duty in letting people know what's going on. And I'm sick and tired of people being broken, miserable all the time, and you stealing their money. Usury. Usury. Yahushua upset all the tables because of the money changers making money off of people's money, debt. They want to keep us in debt. That's the slavery. We were all bought for over $8 million, by the way. And then our parents were given that baby bonus, and our parents never knew. If I had known, I would have never signed my kids over. But I have a friend recently who tried to not sign the birth certificate, and they wanted to charge her $65,000 because she wouldn't sign the birth certificate. I haven't got word yet if she ended up signing or not, but they won't even let you out of the hospital. Each one of those birth certificates is worth $8 million, and everything that you have done over the years has added interest to that. So usury. Yahushua does not want people to charge usury. If you lend money out, you're not supposed to charge usury for it, because that's what keeps everybody in debt. And that's the slavery. I probably already said that. Usury. Historically, the lending of money with interest. Today, the charging of an illegal rate of interest as a condition to lending money. This is in their own law book, Black's Law. John Rook, you said that we're using old stuff. No, we're not. This is the most recent one, and it's very expensive. Like I said, ignorance of the law is no excuse, so please go and do your own study and check out the word de facto, person, driver, traveler, transporter, or a registration. When you go and register your vehicle that you bought out of your hard-earned money, you're going to give it to the government. They don't tell you that. That's another contract. They're supposed to give you full unedited disclosure to every single contract that you sign. If you get a contract and you don't like the stipulations of that contract, then you send it back with what you want. And if they don't like it, they'll send it back. And you keep going until there's an agreement made. That's supposed to be a true contract. And that's with every contract out there. They cannot force you to do something that you do not want to do. Now, the reason why I'm doing this, it's not because of money. It's because of freedom. It's because I do not want my kids and my grandkids to be a slave like I was. I would like to read my agreement to Allison Redford, the first one I got on July 29th, but I can't find it right now. I've got so much paper around here. But I will make another video in a little bit. I have some stuff I have to do for a couple days, but I will make another video and I will read those agreements to you. And like I said, they want to make me look crazy because they don't want this to get out, and they're going to take my life and liberty away from me and throw me in that dirty, rotten prison where there's nothing but evil people in there, and I have never hurt anybody. There's no injured party whatsoever. Nobody got hit. Actually, I am the injured party. He threatened me. He said, get out of the car or I'll haul you out. That's an outright threat. They're taught to be bullies. I'm sure you already know that. If I forget anything, I'll try and add it. I forgot to mention, I'd like to thank Rod Connect for sending that nurse and that policewoman here to see if I was crazy. Because they left saying, no, I don't think you're crazy. I just think you're in with the wrong crowd. And I said, I think I'm in with the right crowd. I'm learning the truth. And I thought this truth would set me free, but there's a lot of persecution. There's a lot of intimidation, but I can't let them. Somebody has to stand up to these people. I mean, I'm 53 years old. I'm single. I have nothing to lose anymore. All my kids are grown and they're all around the world and they're not close to me at all anymore. They're just so scattered out. And that was what they wanted, divide and conquer. I like united we stand and divided we fall. That's better. That's why families should be getting back together so they can learn the truth. Another thing they did too was church pastors and preachers and stuff like that. They were taught what the higher ups wanted them to learn. They were never taught about this slavery. They were never taught about the bond. They were never taught anything that would incriminate them whatsoever. Luckily, there's a few people out there that actually went and did a whole bunch of research. Like our proctor, he's been doing it for 15, 20 years, and he knows quite a bit. So if you have any questions, please post them below. Like I said, if they throw me in jail over this, my court date is October 23rd, and I did a video to Gail Vickery, Stephen Bilodeau, and John Rook and told them I'm not showing up because my lawful excuse is that they're fraud. They're using my name in fraud. I did not give them permission to make my name an all backwards uppercase name. No, I did not give them permission. So that is total outright fraud. So please take a look at your bills. You'll see that your name is all capitalized. Phone and ask questions. They will lie. They will hang up. But the more pressure they get, the better. I'm telling you. Things have to change. We have to stop this slavery. We have to stop the debt. It's very easy to get out of debt, by the way. If you need information on that, post down below and we'll show you how to get out of debt. Very easy. They actually squirm. You can also hold these people in their private capacity for using their authority to intimidate you. You can hold them liable. It's called risk management, and it's through the professional standards branch. I think they just changed it because we're starting to come after them. I did charge those two cops that stopped me because I told him I was a minister, and because of all my agreements, he outright intimidated me, and he has no right to do that. I'm a woman, not a person. You're a man or a woman, not a person. Go check out the word person. There's 8 Black's Law dictionaries. There's 9. I have all 9 of them. And they change the meanings of the words to suit themselves. Believe me, it's such a scam, such a fraud. It's treason. It's money laundering, racketeering. You name it, that's what they're doing. And we have to stop them. John Rook, you said we need to be stopped. No, it's you that needs to be stopped. You are the chief associate judge. Gail Vickery, you're the chief judge. And Stephen Bilodeau, you're the chief prosecutor. You are the evil doers. Now, I've done my research. Please go and do your own research. There's another one called the Protocols of the Learned Elders of Zion. It says that it's a hoax, but if you read it, you're going to see exactly what's going on, and it tells you exactly what they have done to us and what they're going to do to us. So know your enemy. Knowledge is power. What did I do with that? That's a pretty, it was a 33 degree Mason who wrote it, who was feeling guilty. And they did not want to publish because people were starting to figure out what was going on. Actually, there's more and more people every day figuring out what's going on. So if you think I'm crazy, do your research first, please, before you start calling me names. Like, I've been called wingnut and psycho and you name it, when these people are not even learning the truth for themselves. They're just listening to the powers that be that are lying to them. And believe me, the media is nothing but lies, lies, lies. They will not print the truth. That constitutional challenge I had was an absolute joke because these are the guys I'm going against. And they're going to intimidate and threaten and maybe set me up. I don't know. All I know is that I just want to get out of Babylon. That's what Yahuwah tells us to do, get out of Babylon. Read your Bible. You might be able to understand the Bible more now that I've told you this. After my friend told me all this, I never used to understand the Bible until he told me all this, and now I read it and I totally understand it. So don't believe everything you hear. It says trust no man, so don't trust anybody, because now we live in a world that's so selfish and greedy and power hungry. It's unbelievable. And you guys know 20 years ago, it sure is a lot different than what it is now. There's way more intimidation than there was back then. Way more. I don't know what else to say here. I went down and got all my full disclosure. It's supposed to be unedited, but the judges have access to the recordings in court also, where they can change it. How convenient. Why do they not let us have a camera in there when we're defending ourselves? We won't get a lawyer because they have a false oath. We totally refuse to get a lawyer because they do not have a true valid oath. And they try to intimidate you into getting one of their lawyers because, of course, they make money off of it. But they're not letting us defend ourselves at all, and where's the justice in that? That is total obstruction of justice. If you take a camera in there, they'll kick you out. That's ridiculous. We should be, what do they got to hide? Why can we not have a camera in there? And it doesn't even say anywhere in the courthouse that you can't have a camera. It just says a notice to the media that they have to let them know if they're filming. We've gone in there a few times with a camera. We actually got one in, and there's a few videos on the Alman channel that he has put up of the intimidation in court. Now, these people are actors. That's all they are. Even the titles, Mr. and Ms. Misses, it's all persons. Like I said, I'm not a person. Everywhere on TV, all you hear is person, 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 driver, driver, driver. They brain that wash that those words in our head. And they don't even mean what they say they mean. They really don't. Go take a look. You can go to a law library and get some Black's Law dictionaries, or I can send you a copy of the ones I have. I guess that's it. If, like I said, if there's any information you need to know, and please be aware that I imagine they're going to try and set me up with something. Like, I don't drink, I don't do drugs, so I can't see how they're going to do that. Anybody that knows me knows that I smoke marijuana, but that's God's gift of Genesis 1:29. I've been smoking it ever since I was 9 years old, and I'm still alive. Like I said, it's a gift. It says, I give you every herb-bearing seed. And the seed, Genesis 1:29. Honey, it's on the first page of the Bible, eh? And God said, behold, I have given you, that's a gift, every herb-bearing seed. Who are they to tell us we cannot have a tree? You know why? Because it heals. Marijuana heals cancer. If you take the marijuana leaves and eat them, your cancer will go. We should all be eating marijuana leaves every day. You don't get high off of it. You only get high if it's heated. Sorry. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb-bearing seed. Marijuana is a seed. Which is upon the face of all the earth. And every tree, which is marijuana, it's a tree. In the which is the fruit of the tree yielding seed. To you it shall be for meat. Well, I like my meat smoked. And it's my decision. Nobody has authority over me. We are all equal. Please realize that. We have to stand up. We have to stop these people. Yes, there are 10 laws. If you read them, they make so much sense. Nobody gets hurt. Everybody has their freedom. We also have land inherited to us from Yahuwah. I don't know exactly where that is in the Bible yet, but I imagine some people do, and they can post it below. It's just unbelievable what they have done, and we have been submitting ourselves to it because we've been brainwashed into believing that they're our authority when they're not. Yahuwah is our authority. He's the one who created the earth. And I believe that, like, say when you were going downtown, you see those people standing on the corners going, praise God, and making them look crazy. They did that on purpose so people wouldn't read the Bible and learn from it and learn that they have gifts and inheritances and freedoms. It says in here that nobody has authority over you. Who do they think they are, making up all these laws to steal your money? That's exactly what they're doing. Even in the States, they're not part of the Commonwealth, but they're doing the same thing there. I'm not saying we don't need a government. We need a non-corrupt government. Who's watching the police? Who's watching the government? Where there is power, there is corruption. So please, please read. Don't believe anybody. I know I've said it a few times and I've repeated myself a few times, but that's because I want to get it across to you. So I hope there's no more. If I forget anything, I'll do another video because I'll go over it and see if I forgot anything. I don't like to be long-winded. But like I said, do your own research. The protocols of the Elders of Zion, oh my gosh, it's going to blow your mind. Your mouth is going to drop because they have done absolutely everything to us that they said. And it is so in line with this. Like it says right on it that it's a hoax, but it's not. It's true. Everything I've read in there, I've seen happen over my 53 years. So you have a good day and blessings. And hopefully I will not be in jail. And I swear to Yahuwah right now, I will not eat or drink any of their food to protest this. It's not about money. It's about freedom. So thank you very much and you have a good day.